Hey, you guys remember Kyrsten Sinema? No, not that Kyrsten Sinema. You're thinking of the Kyrsten Sinema that you heard from a couple of weeks ago. I'm talking about the other Kyrsten Sinema. These are different people, right? Because we have this footage of Kyrsten Sinema who blasted the false pressure to get 60 votes, who was looking at this whole filibuster thing as like this as a joke. This is 2010. Do we have the same? Oh, wait. Is this Kyrsten Sinema? And the new one is Kyrsten Sinema. Oh, they're both Kyrsten Sinema?
So what does that mean? Well, in the Senate, we no longer have 60 votes. Some would argue that we never had 60 because one of those was Joseph Lieberman. But that's whatever. Yeah, and Nelson too, but really.
Pause it. Now, she's crapping on Joseph Lieberman, and I give her points. Whoever this person is, Joseph Lieberman, incidentally, is one of the chairs of the No Labels Caucus organization, outside expenditure organization. That's where that Joe Manchin tape leaked from the other day. I don't know who this woman is, but I would vote for her for Senate. Go back. Let's start it up again.
That's whatever. Yeah, and Nelson, too, but really Lieberman. So now there's, I think as the president so eloquently said on Wednesday, there's none of this pressure, this false pressure to get to 60. So what that means is that, the Democrats, can stop, kowtowing to Joe Lieberman and instead seek other avenues to move forward with health reform. And so it's likely that the Senate will move forward with a process called reconciliation, which takes only 51 votes. And by the way, it's not unusual. You may recall that before the Democrats took the Senate in 2008, that the Republicans controlled the Senate for quite some time. In fact, since around 1994, they never had 60 votes and they managed to do a lot of really bad things during that time. So the reconciliation process is still quite available and we will use it for good rather than for evil.
Okay, so now she is, I don't know what she, I don't think, if this is 2010, she was not in office at the time. I'm not sure. But what you can hear her saying, if you understand English, is she's saying there's nothing wrong with the use of the reconciliation. There's nothing inherently wrong with it at all. And this was pre-Trump.
Was she a Green at this point?
I think she was. This is back in 2010. Now, my understanding is she was like in, she won her election in 2012, I think. So I don't know what the context is. But nevertheless, this was her opinion on reconciliation back at a time when people didn't even know what it was. So Kyrsten Sinema, maybe there's two different people.
There's a Green Party one and a Democrat one.
Maybe there's two different people. Kyrsten and Kyrsten Sinema. But the bottom line is, I don't know what could have possibly changed. Donald Trump brought the country together so much that she thinks it's wrong to use reconciliation now as opposed to during the Obama administration. Or the Republicans have shown such good faith in the way that they've operated in the interim period that we should give them the benefit of the doubt.
It's pretty... I don't know what it is. Creepy to see somebody who's just basically a empty vessel.
Total cipher.
To parrot
yep.
sort of language that you actually find valuable for explaining the world to people.
Yep.
I think we haven't really seen that here yet because I think the left just hasn't been powerful enough to necessitate it. But you see that a lot in Latin American countries. Politicians will speak in the language of the left and then it turns out like once they get in power, it's nope.
We get a little bit of like populism, right? That people perceive as being left. Obama did a little bit of that. I'm going to put my soft walking shoes on and walk with the union on the picket lines. Bill Clinton did that by playing sax and going out and eating McDonald's, that type of stuff. But we don't get full on leftist language that then gets reversed because they're so terrified of using it in the first place. But there it is. This just breaking. Supreme Court confirms that Justice Breyer has hired four law clerks for the next term. So this dude is just going to ride it out because of a level of narcissism that I think we can't even measure. And I'll tell you something. I know some narcissists. I know some narcissists. Big time. A lot more fun to probably hang out with than Justice Breyer. But I think none of them couldn't be convinced that maybe what they want to do has the ability to shape the lives of 300 million people maybe should come second to the welfare of those 300 million people and the trajectory of millions to come in the future. This guy, unbelievable. That's just, wow.
Folks, there's more of what you've just saw where that came from. That's if you hit the subscribe and like button. Thank you. Really, thank you.